Hi, everybody. So I haven't done one of these in a while, but it's very important that we do share our experiences that we go through, because in this interconnected world, we come to our common humanity. And when we come to our common humanity, we start to realize that there's a commonality that is the common denominator that unites all people in general, and particularly all those that are trying to connect with the Creator, with God, with whatever name that we refer to this reality that we are trying to perceive and trying to live our lives according to, conduct, ideals, motivations, etc. So I wanted to tell you guys, not to make the sound too scripted as I'm driving here between places, that I had an amazing conversation with, I don't know if I'm going to say a friend of mine or a student of mine or a peer or all three, an individual that's actually in one of my classes, and is actually a bit older than me, has an incredible amount of wisdom in life, and is an immigrant from one of the southwestern Asian countries. He's a devout Muslim, and we had maybe a 30 or 45 minute talk today after our class, and it was just like, wow. The point, I can't really go into all the details of what we spoke about, but what I got out of it is that there are people that come from all different parts of the world that have different faiths, that have different backgrounds, but have a common struggle. And I think that really unites people. And when more of us get onto the realization that there's a lot more people that view things in a similar way that we do, that go through experiences that are not much different than our own, and that actually are facing challenges and are trying to deal with those challenges with the recognition that there is a higher calling and a deeply personal, transcendent reality that's connected to our God, to our Creator, to the one that is in charge of our lives, and we're holding on to either it's a text that we hold sacred, or traditions, or religious beliefs, and that these commonalities actually go through and transcend the differences between people, between ethnicity, religious beliefs, backgrounds, educational breakdown, that it becomes very inspiring, very encouraging. Basically, we spoke together about the challenges of society today, how when he came to this country, I forget, it's maybe like between 15 and 20 years ago, something like that, between 1 to 2 decades ago, when he immigrated this country, and he said that this is, out of the whole world, this is the country that has the most religious freedom and the most opportunity. He said that it was actually kind of a shock that right now, living in the 21st century, there's so much pressure by what's popular today, by what's going on, by the educational system, of basically trying to pressure society to go into this moving away from the family, from sacred values, from ideals, from morality. And he said that it's a very big struggle trying to find the right balance when a person is trying to raise their children through the school system in the country that has been basically, in a sense, in his words that I could very much relate to, in a sense, a society that is telling children to separate from their parents, ideals, understandings, ways of life, cultures, values, ethics, morals. And something that he pointed out was that we have to view these children that are growing up today as not in a bad light, because that's what they're told, that's what they're exposed to, and that's the world that they know. And the idea was that I wanted to share with everybody here is that to listen, to not criticize, to not isolate or try to separate the kids out of that society, because where are you going to go? What country are you going to run away to now? Are you going to run away to a country that's half of the world away? Well, this culture war, this value assault is going on there as well. So basically, you can't really live in a bubble. So you have to listen. You have to try not to come across right away as, no, they're wrong and this is right. Just listen. Be open. Ask about their friends, about their their lives, and then have personal family time over dinner, over get-togethers, whether you eat together or pray together, and have small conversations of, okay, let's compare these values with society today, with what's demonstrated to us as apparently what the way things are supposed to go according to the masses, the majority of society, and then let's compare that with our ideals or your ideals or what we're trying to aspire to, and let's just honestly compare and see how these lifestyles are, where's their happiness, and basically slowly but surely getting people not to right away reject another idea, another entity, another ideology, but accept, be open to it, listen, and then slowly but surely have your kids or your friends or your family members to compare in a very non-threatening way. And he said, slowly but surely, it takes time, but years, weeks, months, years of this, they'll start to make the proper mature understandings of what's going on. And they'll start to come to their own conclusions based on comparative analysis. If you try to tell a person to reject everything that's going on around them, then they might have the opposite effect. And so what I wanted to just point out is that these are real situations, real issues. And he said that a lot of the people coming from his home country, a lot of families that came from there to America, were not able to be hold together. They fell apart because of this huge basically culture war. And he said it's unfortunate that the family structure is so important for healthy lifestyles, and it's been having a toll and playing a toll on those lifestyles, on those families, because of just the obvious. So he said many people criticize his approach and say, you know what, you're not firm enough, you're not strict enough. But he says over on the long run, if you don't reject right away, but you accept and embrace and slowly but surely keep the connection going and teach your children, your family members, your colleagues, your friends, how to compare, not to negate, but to compare and to come to the right conclusions, that they will see that the love, the attention, and the emphasis you put forth, that goes much further and much stronger over the long run than right away starting to basically try to, you know, block certain things out or put people in certain bubbles. So that to me was very encouraging, because, you know, so many more people are going through many questions and many struggles, and are finding a support system that's a lot wider than even their own family or their own even religion or their own ethnicity, that this is what unites humanity. And if we start to recognize and focus on these unifications, on these similarities and these commonalities between the souls in the world that belong to different groups, different ethnicities, different religions, but are really trying to hold on to and strengthen and pass along these time immemorial values, these ethics that transcend time, that come back to the most ancient of days, to the creator of us all, that go even before religions or at the root of all of the faith of the world, then these are the things that will bring people together and will actually help humanity advance and work together and not fall apart. So I wanted to share that with you guys because that was very inspirational for me, and I hope that you all found something that you can walk away with and hopefully open up the lines of communication and to see that there are many more people that are in the same boat going forward in the same direction, trying to connect to the good things that unify all of humanity, that go beyond the borders of separation, of ethnicity, tribal affiliation, religion. And this is where the souls of humanity need to unite and to share the wealth that belongs to all of us in a positive, proactive, encouraging, non-condescending way with all of us today. Okay, have a great day.